Lesson 7. Managing resource loading. One of the most important challenges for a project manager is to plan and track resource loading. Correct resource loading helps all of your tasks and the project itself to run smoothly and on time. Let's learn how to manage resource loading with Concept Draw Project. Switch to the Resource Usage Dashboard. Here you can see a list of all resources and a visual dashboard of your resource loading. For each resource, you can see overloaded periods, periods with normal loading, and periods with low loading. Zero loading has no graphical display. You can find out what the loading for an exact period consists of. Expand the list using the plus symbol. Now you can see all tasks assigned to this resource. To change a loading, you can go to the selected task on your Gantt chart by using the context menu, and then change the task assignment using the Assign Resource dialog. Switch to the Reports tab and click on the Resource Usage Diagram icon. The Visual Resource Usage Diagram will open in Concept Draw Pro in presentation mode. This multi-page document contains a common resource usage diagram and details of each resource. You can also briefly track the resource loading indicator on Project Dashboard. Learn more about this in Lesson 12. Tracking resource loading is a key factor in your project's success. It's easy to manage resource loading with Concept Draw Project. Lesson 8. Annotating project's tasks with text notes and color markers. When managing a project with a large number of tasks, it's helpful to be able to make notes for yourself and other project participants. It's more than easy with Concept Draw Project. The traditional way is to add text notes to tasks. You can make notes visible in the table part of a Gantt chart using the column customization feature. Note that you can create a report with a list of all tasks and their notes. It is available from the Reports tab under the Phase Start section. You can also change the time period for this report. Learn how to do this in Lesson 10. Now it's possible to make notes directly on the Gantt chart by using the Text Box feature. Each text box is bounded to a task. Select a task and then click the Add Text Box button on the toolbar. You can resize the text box or move it. Another way to mark specific tasks is by using colored markers. It's easy to mark tasks or resources directly from the toolbar. Using the Edit Markers dialog, you can prompt yourself regarding what each color means. Now you can pay attention to really important tasks and keep focused on managing your project. Text notes, text boxes, and visual markers save time when you are tracking your project daily. Lesson 9. Defining dependencies between tasks. As we noted in Lesson 4, there are different types of dependencies between tasks. Let's figure out how to manage this. Finish to start is used when the dependent task cannot begin until the task that it depends on is complete. Start to start helps when the dependent task cannot begin until the task that it depends on begins. The dependent task can start at any time after the task that it depends on begins. Finish to finish means that the dependent task cannot be completed until the task that it depends on is completed. The dependent task can be completed at any time after the task that it depends on is completed. Start to finish means the dependent task cannot be completed until the task that it depends on begins. The dependent task can be completed at any time after the task that it depends on begins. A visual depiction of dependencies on a Gantt chart is helpful, but for larger projects, it's hard to browse the dependencies. In this case, you can make the predecessors and successors columns visible in the table part of a Gantt chart and set the links using the task numbers. Using the predecessors dialog, you can also set a predecessor for any task and set a type of dependency. Determining a task's dependencies ensures that all tasks can be completed on schedule. Lesson 10. Generating sets of reports, report settings. When generating reports, sometimes one is not enough. This is where ConceptRaw Project's report sets can help you out. You can produce multiple reports with just one click. Let's find out how. There are more than 50 tabular reports in ConceptRaw Project. Reports are combined into case-oriented sets. Each set has an appropriate period setting. For example, the set Current Activities Weekly gives you information about completed or critical tasks, tasks that are yet to begin, and tasks in project for that current week. To generate a set of reports, you need to click on a set's name. To generate a specific report, click on that report's name. What do you do if you found a helpful report, but the time period is not suitable? For example, you'd like to generate a cost report set for the project's entire lifeline. It's easy to do. In the Reports menu, select the Customize Reports option. The Reports dialog will appear. Select the set you need and choose the report period from the predefined periods or by using the Calendar option. This option applies to all reports in the set. Note that you can also change the report period for a separate report. Now you will get reports with the report period that suits your needs. ConceptRaw Project gives you the ability to generate any report set you need with just one click. It's a great time saver for a project manager. Lesson 11, Visual Project Diagrams. When discussing your project with your team, you sometimes need to focus your audience on different project aspects. Now it's easy thanks to the visual project diagrams in ConceptRaw Project. Switch to the Reports tab. Here you can see a gallery of the project diagrams. Click on a diagrams icon. The diagram will open in ConceptRaw Pro. Let's take a closer look at the different diagrams available. The Gantt chart diagram presents a basic view of your project. This can help during the early stages of discussion or when presenting to stakeholders. PERT charts allow the tasks in a particular project to be analysed, with attention paid to the time required to complete each task and the minimum time required to finish the entire project. The resource calendar gives you a two-page document for each resource. The first page is the resource usage diagram. The second page is a personal calendar detailing the resources tasks. The timeline diagram gives you a timeline of all your projects and their level of completion on one page. The milestone chart shows milestones with dates and relations contained on a timeline. Radial task structure is an alternative way to visually analyze task structure level by level. The resource usage diagram is a multi-page document containing resource common loading information and detailed loading for each resource. The work breakdown structure shows the deconstruction of a project into smaller components. Transforming project data into different visual forms is a productive way of looking at your project from different perspectives. It also helps you deliver project information in a suitable way, depending on your objectives and audience. Lesson 12, Visual Project Dashboard. Every project manager dreams of having all their key project information on one screen. Now it's possible with ConceptRaw Project. Switch to the Reports tab. You can find Project Dashboard in the Dashboards group. It takes just one click to generate. Project Dashboard opens in Concept Draw Pro. Project Dashboard contains a summary of information, project completion indicator, cost and budget, task completion, resource allocation, and a resource and tasks indicator. Indicators have a common color notation. Red denotes a late project or task, yellow shows a normal status, and green indicates any tasks and projects that are ahead of schedule. Some indicators have links to additional graphical reports. For example, if you find out that you have 5 late tasks, you can easily find out which exact tasks are late by double-clicking on the link. Here you can find a list of late tasks with detailed information regarding their planned and actual level of completion and any assigned resources. You can then return to the dashboard. Note that the project dashboard updates information each time you save a project file, so all changes will appear on the dashboard immediately after saving. You can also get the dashboard for multiple projects. Learn how to do this in Lesson 14. With Concept Draw Projects Dashboard, you will always have up-to-date key project information on one page. This tells you exactly where you need to direct your management efforts. Lesson 13, communication with project team via micro reports. Being able to relay information quickly to your team is a huge benefit for work efficiency. Concept Draw Project gives you an opportunity to communicate with your team faster by using micro reports. A micro report is a small piece of project information associated with a specific task, phase, resource, or project, which you can send via email. Micro reports are available by right-clicking the context menu. You can report any task status by using the Task Status micro report. It gives you the level of completion and background information about the task. For each phase, you're able to communicate a list of tasks scheduled for the current day and critical tasks or resources involved in the day's activities. You can inform a project participant about his tasks for the day, all his assignments and objectives, and any projects or critical tasks that need special attention. You can also report today's task list, resources involved that day, and forthcoming milestones. The micro report feature is a great time saver for daily communication with your team, and it allows you to report project statuses quickly and easily. Lesson 14, printing your project. An important feature of Project is the ability to print part of or your entire project. You may need a hard copy to present to team members or for use in meetings. There are a range of options to help you show the information you need. Let's go through them. Switch to Print Preview by using the menu or by pressing Ctrl P. Print Preview shows you the same image that will appear on paper. By default, the project is fitted to one page. You can change the scale setting to print with 100% scale or select the appropriate scaling. You can print the Gantt chart as is or print the tabular part only. Sometimes you need to print part of a project for a specific period. Set the date range by using the timescale group on the toolbar and you'll get this period printed. Depending on your needs, you can set the margins by using predefined settings or change it manually by dragging and dropping the margin lines. You can also change the page's orientation and select an appropriate page size. As a finishing touch, you need to place a legend. There are three options: place a legend on every page, on separate pages, or not at all. Note that when using the print button, you'll print the current view. To print other views, you need to switch to the required view and then use the print function. Now you can select your printer and click on the print button. Concept Draw Project gives you the ability to print all projects and views with just one click. Change the Select View to Print option from active view to multi-project. You can also save this setting for future work. Now you know how to get a hard copy of your project.